the Australian Labor Party. Their name is a point of frustration for Wordle fans out there.
Mate, this is just impossible.
It's one of Australia's oldest political parties, and it was the party that delivered our first and so far only female Prime Minister. It's currently led by...
Mr Albanese.
Not quite. It's Anthony Albanese.
It's Albanese.
But where did the Labor Party come from and who are they now? The Australian Labor Party grew from Australia's labour and union movement in the 1890s. Back then, working conditions were, let's just say, not great. So trade unions were formed to better protect the rights of workers. They wanted their demands taken seriously by the government, and so they formed the Labor Party. As for the spelling, well, it has to do with the global labour movement at the time. A lot of writing on the subject was American, hence the American English spelling. Labour entered federal politics during the first Commonwealth election in 1901. They campaigned for the 8-hour working day and the creation of the minimum working wage, but they were also largely against immigration. More recently, Labor is known for introducing universal healthcare in 1974, the Native Title Act in 1993, and setting up the National Disability Insurance Scheme, the NDIS, in 2013. The party's longest-serving leader and Labor royalty was Bob Hawke. Some other best-known Labor leaders include Gough Whitlam, who was removed as PM after controversially being dismissed by the Governor-General.
Well, may we say, God save the Queen. Because nothing will save the Governor-General.
Kevin Rudd, who was pushed out by Australia's first female PM, Julia Gillard. Who then had the same done to her by Kevin Rudd. Oh, and there was also Bill Shorten. Remember him? Anthony Albanese is the party's current leader, and they're experiencing tensions within their own ranks over energy and climate change policies. So how does the party stack up to its original manifesto?
The thing that the Labor Party started out doing was representing working people. By and large, they were members of unions, and so representing working people was a proud and unambiguous agenda of the Labor Party. The Labor Party we see today represents working people, but it represents more than that, and it seeks to be a party for all Australians, effectively. Now, whether it actually succeeds in that or not, that's up to voters at elections. Labor is now a party that is really wrestling with sort of two elements of its character, the sort of urban left agenda, which is very environmentally conscious and socially progressive, and its more conservative industrial base, and the vestiges of which I think are probably best expressed in that coal mining sector. And so this is a problem for both sides of politics, and probably more so, though, I think, for Labor.